here with Kimmy Gatewood and Rebekka Johnson from GLOW.
Yeah,
I love this show so much.
It's such a good show.
Thank you.
It was like a very, very real part of me growing up. My brother and I would be like, you stop what you're doing. Sit here and watch GLOW.
You do it. Get in here. Watch this show.
Little brother.
Your little brother's?
My big brother.
It's like, he sounds like a beast.
My little brother, he was 3 at the time.
Beat up still happened.
Wow. Brett. I mean, you guys are awesome on the show. It's coming back like this week.
Friday.
The 29th.
Friday.
Did you do any wrestling before? Did you have to like train for it? Did you do any amateur wrestling?
There we are.
Well, you know, it's funny. They called me, we did 4 weeks of wrestling training, and they ended up calling me Kimmy one time at the beginning of season 1 because I would just get moves on the first try. And they said, do you have like an underground wrestling background? You have a ring in your backyard? And I was like, no. I think it was like a lot of pratfalls that helped me.
Right.
Yeah, the greatest thing was that Kimmy and I were partners, and Kimmy was the best wrestler in wrestling training, and I was the worst, which is so fun when you're paired up together. It's like really just like so good for your self-esteem. Gives you a lot to work through in therapy.
And in the ring.
Too bad I had to fight with her instead of against her.
Did it like bleed into being angry at her and bitter that she was fun?
No, it's fun actually.
I would be stressed out sometimes though, where I'd be like, oh God, if I'm not good enough, like what if that means that we don't get enough like scenes, and I would be upset with myself about it.
But we ended up like wrestling a ton in season 2. And they got bigger and like the moves got bigger and better. And season 2, everybody came back. We had 4 weeks more of wrestling training, which we thought we were going to forget everything, you know, because we shoot like 9 months
apart. You don't wrestle
for
like 8 months. Yeah.
Right. Surprisingly, you don't wrestle between seasons.
Yeah. It doesn't come up that often.
There's no like spring training they put you through. Okay, got it.
I wish they would.
Yeah, I know. But we did 4 weeks with our trainer, Chavo Guerrero Jr. For any wrestling fans out there, he's a legend. And
he's amazing.
His uncle actually trained the original GLOW Girls. Yeah. And he trained us. Which is, so they have a ton of stories. Like, if you watch the documentary, like, he really did choke somebody out and put her to sleep, basically.
You know, maybe not such a great thing to do.
Sure,
but we were like, we didn't sign up for that. They were very gentle with us. They treated us like, it was like a kindergarten wrestling.
They treated us like the stars that we are.
Yeah.
So on the show, you guys are the beatdown biddies, but if you were to give yourselves a name as a duo in real life, what would you call yourselves?
God, well, we're in a real life comedy trio called the Apple Sisters.
Yes.
That's the plug there.
And jingle's we also, been in my head all day, whistling in the kitchen. Go ahead.
We've owned a feather hair company accessory called the Nerds of a Feather.
Yeah, I think that would be. We'd tickle tickle people till they were incapacitated, I think, with some feathers. We'd be like wearing glasses, like,
and you look gorgeous.
still beat down biddies.
I know, can't get rid of the voice.
Okay, so a lot of the characters have these almost like reductive, stereotypical wrestling personas, whether it's race, gender, age.
Yeah.
But you are able to flip it where I don't know when I have ever else laughed at Welfare Queen. Like, you know what I mean? It's not in my soul. But you are able to flip it to where it's comical and almost liberating, a little empowering. I want to know, is it difficult to kind of own some of these roles?
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you want to?
Yeah,
about
we had
episode 7.
So in episode 7 in season 1, we had to play KKK members against Welfare Queen and Junk Chain, and so it was really, honestly, like we were given a taste of what it feels like to have to play the worst version of a stereotype for your race, right? Because like KKK member, the worst, right? Yeah. We can all agree, maybe not Paul Ryan, but all of the rest of us
can agree.
Yeah.
We're still working on the rest of the country.
But in wrestling, you know, it's all about the good versus the bad.
They're
like
heels and faces. So heels are the bad guys, faces are the good guys.
Yeah.
And so if we were the ultimate heels, the bad guys, then we would make our partners look better.
Yeah, so we end up making like Kia and Sadell look awesome by them kicking our buns. And but I prefer the term buns.
Kia Stevens is a real wrestler from WWE, and she's wrestled for years, and she was given a character named Awesome Kong. Now, if you think about the context of that name, it's terrible. But she said, okay, well, if they're gonna call me Awesome Kong, I'm going to be feared by everyone and respected and own the name. And I think that all of this history in wrestling is like informed the show.
And there was an actual match where there were people playing KKK versus a black man, and like that actually happened in the early 90s. And so everything that's on the show, there's something that it's based on, and so we're sort of shedding light on that.
Yeah, but it's so real. The wrestler Booker T always talks about like some when he was beginning, starting to do this.
Yeah.
But you guys, you do it so well.
Yeah. So I first interviewed you guys like a bajillion years ago as the Apple Sisters.
Yeah.
It was like in Chicago in a hotel. I think it was my first interview ever.
Yes.
But it like won the Chicago. You guys like won the Chicago Sketch Fest. They were like, they've gotten standing ovations like 3 days in a row. And we're like, let's see if we can get the Apple Sisters. And so
we're hoping for one today.
And then again later you did it. Well, yeah, well, that'll happen. Depends on if I survive.
We're begging
it. And then you guys do comedy, a lot of improv. Is the improv, do you use that when you're shooting for GLOW?
Yeah, actually they don't, there's no improv really on the show, but they allow Rebekka and I to improvise.
Yeah, when we're playing the Beatdown Biddies, they kind of will write dialogue for us, but they say that we can do it whatever we want.
It's just kind of like Rebekka and Kimmy will figure out something funny.
Yeah.
Really?
And so
you write that in the script, lazy like writers, come on.
No, we love it. It's actually like our dream come true to be able to write bits for ourselves and they're utilizing like this thing that we've worked on for 20 years. So it's just so awesome that we get to do that. And so, you know, there'll be other times where we'll be like throwing lines in and they'll be like, okay, now stick to the script. reel it back in, girls.
And also, real wrestling, which we didn't really know, everybody thinks it's choreographed, but it's not. They basically know the beginning and the end. Our wrestling is choreographed, but in actual WWE, they improvise all of their wrestling moves.
Yeah, they all know a bunch of moves and then they just slam them together.
I would love to see the wrestling, but we're out of time. We can't do the part where
we
beat me up.
We have time. Pieces clogged. We have time.
We're gonna move the set around.
We'll make time.
We'll be right back in zero seconds.
You should start stretching.
All right, we've magically transformed this stage into a wrestling arena. Wow.
It's amazing. I mean, it's up to code. It's the exact right shape, you know, like trapezoidal.
There's like folding chairs hidden underneath that we can smack you with.
And hopefully there won't be any smacking. Kimmy and Rebekka are going to teach me a wrestling move. So what are you going to teach? I'm going to hand this off.
So this is the pop trigger, pop culture inspired wrestling move by the Seth Rogen and Paul Ryan story.
Yeah, it's called the Rogen's Hero.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're just going to show it to you. Pretty simple move, but very effective.
And Brett, make sure that you're watching me.
Mostly for the acting chops.
Part. Yeah, yeah.
I'm Seth Rogen, and I'm here stoned with my beard.
And I'm Paul Ryan, and I'm here not stoned with my non-beard, because I probably can't grow one. Anyway.
Dead on impression. I'm sure you thought he was here. Okay, here we go.
Stop for my SNL tape. Okay.
Here we go.
Seth Rogen, can I have a picture?
Never, man.
My kids are here.
And
see. Wrestling. Okay, so now I'm going to play... Seth Rogen. It's really been like a dream character to play in my whole life. And you're going to be Paul Ryan.
Okay. I'm a little scared of the handshake thing.
Just go with it.
Okay.
Have you ever shaken anyone's hand?
Yes.
Great. That's all you need to know.
I'll draw from that. Okay. So can I please have a picture, Seth Rogen?
Hell no, bro.
I'm going to come in for what we call the feckless gut punch, which you can really use at any pop culture story this week. Here it comes, buddy. Sour!
Yeah, that's also called the Pineapple Express.
Do P.O.P.P. all the way home. Thank you, and scene.
This absolutely made my Monday. I wish we could do this every show.